What's up, gold diggers? Kimberly Olson here in the house, also known as the Gold Digger Girl. And we are going to do a rocking training today that is not for the faint of heart, because we are going to talk about recruiting like a rock star. We're going to talk about big numbers, big goals, getting out there and hustling. What does it take to get double digits of number of people you're recruiting into your business? I'm going to share all my tips and tricks with you right now. I just thought of something else. I'm going to add it to my list because I'm giving you all the goods right now, okay? So go ahead and put one in the comments if you're watching this live. Put two if you're watching the replay. If you're new and you've never seen my videos before, welcome. Super happy to have you. If you share this out, you get bonus points, okay? I watch and I see who shares my stuff out. You go on my awesome list, okay? So share this out. This would be great for anybody that is recruiting. Anyone who's building a business who needs to get more people on their team. So I think most of you have team pages. Share this into your team pages. Share this on your personal page, wherever you want to. Share, 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 share. I just want to say I got this dress for $8. I'm just throwing it out there. So why don't you, in the comments, it's supposed to be like 78 today in Austin. So I'm like, I need to wear like a summer dress. Even though I wore boots last week, it's cool. Why don't you in the comments share with me an awesome steal that you got when shopping? Because I never shop. So I got this for our beach trip in Mexico in January and I'm wearing it today. $8. I mean, seriously, how awesome is that? But that's not what we're talking about today. But in the comments, let me know a little awesome purchase you've made recently. So when it comes to recruiting, I'm going to give you five, with a bonus tip, I'm going to give you five key things I have done to recruit an average of 10 people per month. And since January 1st, when I launched with my new company, my team collectively has recruited almost 200 people. And that's a lot of people. So, and it's just people building the business. That's not counting customers or anything. That's a lot, okay? So I'm gonna teach you guys exactly what we've done. I'm gonna share that with you. And my hope is that you turn around and do the same thing as well, and you start to see an increase with your numbers, okay? So let's get into it. Okay, first thing, and this is probably, aside from number five, number one is probably the most important, okay? Number one is posture. Posture. What does posture mean? Posture is how you show up. Posture is how you communicate. Posture is your conviction in what you have to offer. It has to be so rock solid, so next level that people are just like, whoa. I heard this yesterday. Have you guys seen House of Cards? So Scott and I just finished season two, I think, and it's really good. Very manipulative, but very good. Do you notice the main character, Frank Underwood, often wins debates and arguments and convincing people because his posture is stronger? The person who is more steadfast in their point of view, thank you, Anna. You guys share this out and put share it in the comments, okay? The person who has more conviction, the person who is more steady and has more resolve and confidence in themselves will win. This is why, you know, if you're having an argument with your husband, do you ever feel like, I don't know if you're married or a friend or whatever, and you're just like, oh, I just like never know what to say and I feel like I just lose the conversation? It's because you didn't really have that conviction and that strength to just come in guns blazing. Well, it's a little different, obviously, in the landscape of recruiting, but what posture means is that you are, so there's two people in the conversation, this is your posture. You are more confident, you are more steadfast, you have more resolve, belief, and conviction in yourself and what you have to offer than the other person. Posture. So my first tip, and the thing that I have, is I have posture. I'm super confident in my products. I know they're life-changing. I know my comp plan is the best one out there. I'll put it against anything. And I know for sure the people, meaning my leadership team and my environment of my team, is superior. I'm positive. So how do I come across versus how I was 2 years ago? This is my 2-year anniversary this month. I did not have posture at all. I was like, so will you take a look at my video? And I would like hold my breath and pray. And then like 1 out of 10 people would say yes. And I was like, I have a pulse. And I was like, so did you watch the video? I mean, I had no posture. People were like recruiting me. They're like, so yeah, I saw your thing, but I wanted to tell you what I'm doing. And I'm like, oh, what is it? Like, I had no posture, okay? So if you don't have any posture, it's okay. You gotta get your posture. Get your posture pants on, okay? Another way to have posture is how you're showing up on social media. I just did an interview with Angela Szymanski in the Gold Diggers of Network Marketing. Go watch that because she can help you. She actually does it as a business. Is she helps independent business owners of how to show up in social media more intentionally, authentically, engage and, you know, recruit people. And if you aren't showing up on social media every day intentionally and you're not doing posting content, you're not trying to interact with people, you're not doing Facebook Lives, in my opinion, you're not rocking your attraction marketing at all. You're like hoping people come. You're like, oh, maybe if I just do this post, like it doesn't work that way. You have to be so confident. I cannot stress the confidence again. And if you're like, I'm just not confident, you get confident by becoming competent. That's Danielle Delgado's, one of her quotes. Got that from her. Competence builds confidence. When you do something over and over again, you become competent. And then you become confident as a byproduct. I, again, knew nothing about social media a year and a half ago. I didn't even go on Facebook at all, you guys. I didn't even know how to tag people. I didn't even know how, like, I don't even know. I didn't even have the app on my phone. Like, I had no clue what was going on. Okay, so if I can learn it, you can learn it. But your attraction marketing needs to be rock solid. Don't be posting your company name, company links, join my team, buy my stuff. That's selling. That's not attraction marketing. Watch my page. I'll be a great example of how to show up. Mine's a little bit different because I obviously am an influencer, but you got to start somewhere. Okay, so look at my stuff for inspiration. Attraction marketing is huge when it comes to posture because people reach out to me because I have posture. They see that I'm confident. They see that I know what I'm doing. People want to join somebody that knows what they're doing, right? Like, you don't want to just join your friend who's like, oh, I just joined network marketing yesterday. I have no idea what I'm doing. Like, you might do it to help her, but truly you want to join somebody who knows what they're doing, right? Okay. Next is onboarding. Okay. I cannot stress this either enough. I feel like all of this is so important, but if you truly want results and you want to be recruiting 10 people a month, this is how you do it. Okay. Next one is onboarding. You have to have a system of onboarding. Okay. This is where you have duplication happening. Okay. Where you get 200 people, almost 200 people joining your team in a matter of a couple months because it's duplication. It's not just me recruiting everybody on my team and having people join my team and in our movement and what we're doing because it's different. It's because my team is duplicating. We have tools set up where somebody joins and it's step by step. This is exactly what you do to get started. You're brand new, you just spent money, or you just decided to grow a business and you have no idea what you're doing. Part of you is like, what did I just do, right? The other part of you is like, you have to confidently know what to do with your new people. How many of you before have started with a company and there was no onboarding? Or have you brought people on and you just didn't feel like you knew what to do with them? That was me before. I had no idea. I was just like, okay, I don't know what to do with them. They're new. Like, I feel like they should, you know, hopefully get in the group. And yeah, I told them, you know, if they need help, I'm here. That's not enough. They need step-by-step to get into activity right away. So the thing that I did differently and that I have in place and my whole team does it is we have an onboarding system. So we are able to duplicate people and we are able to continue to recruit. We're not sitting there reinventing the wheel over and over again. Everybody on my team isn't trying to figure out what to do with the new person, right? They're just plugging them into the tools that we already have. Speaking of tools, number three is having tools in place. You want to have tools already in place, meaning go to your upline. What can you plug into that's already done? Is there somebody on your team? Could you divvy up? Like maybe you need some video tutorials created. Could you ask some people on your team that are rising stars or people who are already having success? Could you ask them, hey, can we get together and come up with a plan? Everyone can raise their hand and volunteer to take a different piece of the puzzle. Let's collectively figure out what tools we need. You know, do we need a videos on how does a customer order, or a video on, you know, how to sample people. Like, what are the things that we need? Let's all together band together and come up with those where you're not creating everything. If you're creating the team page and the customer group and the onboarding and all the videos, you've gotten yourself into management mode. It's true. It happens all the time. Every time I talk to somebody who their business isn't growing, but was, I'm like, what happened? They're like, I don't know. I'm just not recruiting as many people. Why? Well, I have these three new people that started and I've been helping them. 80% of your business needs to be on your own business. Income producing activities. Anytime you do something, ask yourself, is this making me money? Now, working with your team is going to make you money, so you do want to help that person. But if you have tools in place, you plug them into the tools and you let the tools do the work, okay? 20% of the time, you're working with those people, but for sure the ones that are raising their hands working the business, not the ones that are just hanging out and just signed up just to be a part of the team. You need to be spending your time with the people who are actually working the business and growing, okay? So don't get into management mode. It's so easy to do. Number four is I followed up, okay? So what people are doing is they've got like five people that they're trying to bring into their team, and then they just, thanks for sharing, Chrissy, they just keep following up with those same five people month after month after month. So you're like, oh, how's it going? Well, you know, I think Carol might join. You know, she almost did last month, but then she was waiting for her tax rebate to come. So then I talked to Carol when her tax rebate came this month, and she actually had an unexpected leak in her house, so she had to like replace the basement. You can't just be hanging out waiting for Carol, guys. You got to go find some more people, okay? You got to go out there and you have to follow up, and you have to continue to recruit with the posture and the attraction marketing, connecting. When you do attraction marketing, your funnel will be full. My funnel is always full, okay? Even just reaching out to people on your friends list, happy birthday. Your funnel will get full if you do it the right way, okay? So follow up with the people who show interest. Follow up with the people who say, sure, I'll check it out. Follow up with the people who say they'll try a sample, or maybe they're not ready for the business. Let's see if we can get them to become a customer, right? Follow up with your customers. Hey, have you ever thought about the business side? Would you host an online event for me? Would you post something on social media? Invite people to opportunity videos. If your team, your upline, doesn't have some kind of weekly opportunity video for people to plug in, how can people find out what you're doing? Like, you can't just send a video in Messenger and expect people to be wanting to jump on board. I don't like watching videos. Ask anybody. I'm like, it's 4 minutes. I don't even know. Maybe I'll play it while I'm brushing my teeth. Like, my brain doesn't work that way. I'm just like, right? Results, results, results. So if you're just doing the old school send a video, oh, I sent him a video Messenger. No. You need weekly ways for people to plug into what is going on in your team. They need to feel like they're a part of it. They need a little glimpse, okay? Do you have a weekly team call you can invite them to? Is there some kind of new business builder opportunity, Facebook Live or webinar or something that you can invite people to? Is there a corporate call, a company call? You know, are there any other events that you're doing, okay? That is the type of thing that you want to be thinking about when it comes to follow-up. Offer them something. Say, hey, we're putting this together. Would you come check it out? Hey, there's this Zoom. I'd love for you to take a look, because then they're getting to see what it's about, to feel it. Like, do they like the feel of your team? If you're doing it right, they're going to love it. They're going to want to be a part of it. And it's going to be fun and exciting and energetic, a lot different than their lame thing going on with their current company. Otherwise, they wouldn't even be looking, right? And I say that because I've worked my tail off to build what I've built with my team, and my leaders are working their tails off like crazy, working themselves up. They are so exhausted. They're working so hard. We have fought tooth and nail to create the environment that we have, and we are proud of it. Do you have that? Okay. Create it. If you don't, you have to figure that out. You guys, you cannot just keep following up. How's it going? You want to join? Want to join? Want to join? It doesn't work. Look at your results. Is it working? The truth, the proof is always in the pudding, right? Okay. Number five, last tip is I worked my ass off. Okay, in order to recruit an average of 10 people per month direct and almost 200 people with my team since January 1st, is I've worked and continue to work my tail off. Okay, you guys know, you see me in Messenger sometimes at 1 a.m., 1:30 a.m. Last night I was like, I did not want to be up at, you know, almost 2 o'clock in the morning. No, sure didn't. And I voice messaged my assistant. I was like, hey, we need to do this tomorrow. And she's like, you're still up? What are you? Cause she's a late owl too. A late owl, a night owl. Oh my gosh. I just made that up. It's night owl, right? I don't know. Anyways, she's up late too. So she happened to respond, and she's just like, oh my word. Like, she gets it. And, she's a huge cheerleader of mine, but she knows. Okay. And this is not to toot my own horn. I'm telling you what it takes to make this happen. If you want to recruit one person a month, that's awesome. I am so happy, but you are going to have a very little residual income. And a lot of people just want to be a part of something. So if that's you, great. But you're watching this video because I said, how do you recruit 10 people per month? You can't rely on the people who got you to where you are to get you where you want to be in 3 months. You cannot rely on the people who have gotten you to where you are today to get you to where you want to be 90 days from now. because there's this thing called attrition. There's this thing called life. There's this thing called people quitting. And if you don't keep filling up your pipeline with new people, the people currently on your team are going to lose their momentum and excitement. They don't have that social proof of people having success, okay? Our team that I have, it's not just my team, it's my leaders too. Our team crushes it when it comes to new people joining and hitting all of our newbie bonuses. So much so that the CEO was reaching out to my upline like, what are they doing? Like, the results are amazing. So all the people who have been doing this for a bit see that and they're reminded like, oh yeah, okay, this stuff works. People are having success. If you've got the same old people hanging out every freaking month on your team calls, there's no excitement, there's no energy, right? Unless you have like a really, really big team. So you wanna constantly be filling that funnel up, getting new people onto your team, working your tail off, okay? I listened to Iggy's song. I might dance for you guys in my Facebook stories at some point. Work. Her song Work, she's been working on, I don't even know how the words go. She's working on making that money, right? She is working. She talks about going to Miami when she was 16 years old, no family, no job, no money, and she made it happen, okay? We're lucky that most of us aren't like Iggy, but hey, we all have our stories, right? And if you want it bad enough, you're gonna work for it. So maybe ask yourself, have I been recruiting every day? Have I been posting on social media? Have I been following up with people? Am I organized? Do I have a list or do I have a notebook, some sticky notes? I've got, you know, Gina's phone number on my hand. That's not a professional business where you're gonna build multiple six figures unless you just luck out, okay? So if you want it, you guys, you can all make multiple six figures, like all of you can watching this. I'm dead serious. So if you want it bad enough or you wanna quit your job or get your family out of debt, the choice is yours. You all have the ability to do it with your network marketing business, every single one of you. Just implement these things we talked about. Hustle, don't make any excuses, don't let life get in the way, and just want it bad enough. Visualize it every single freaking day. See yourself having the success that you want. Keep it on the forefront of your mind. And you know what? I have obstacles too. I have stuff happen. Yesterday, literally, Scott got home. I put this gallon of milk, or half a gallon of milk, because we had people visiting, on its side. Goes to show how much I know about milk. All the milk went down the whole fridge, and Elise screamed for like 3 hours yesterday, and we came back from a run, got in the house, the milk was everywhere, and I was just like, I seriously want to run away from my life right now for 5 seconds. But I'm human too, guys. Like, I'm not sitting here like Miss Pollyanna all day long having awesome stuff happen, okay? Somebody, while I was watching this, unsubscribed from my messenger bot on my business page. That's not fun. Oh well, move on. Like, I'm not gonna let some person who unsubscribed to my bot kill my mojo, right? Like, I gotta keep my mindset to be stronger than the obstacles that show up in my day, because that's how I'm gonna grow and that's how I'm gonna keep crushing it. And I want that for you as well. So use those tips. Tonight is my Facebook groups workshop. If you are not using Facebook groups to nurture your prospects, grow relationships with them, offer value, you can use it for your customers, your prospects, your business builders. You can use it for your personal branding. You can use it for challenges, raffle campaigns. You can do it for events, all kinds of things. So my groups range from, I have a new one that's almost at 800 people to one that's over 11,000. I have a lot of groups, and with all the Facebook algorithms, everything's been wacko when it comes to the ATM method, ad tag message. You can't do that anymore. You can't add people to a group and expect them to get in there and watch the video. It's just not working. So we're gonna go through a new sales funnel. We're gonna go through all, like, what do you post? What kind of content? How do you get engagement? All that stuff. So just put link in the comments, L-I-N-K. That's tonight. You'll have access to the replay for life. So put L-I-N-K, let's get you in there. And then the weight loss challenge is also gonna be in the comments. So put link in the comments and Messenger will tell you about the weight loss challenge. Huge prizes on the table. We are raffling off $1,000 worth of prizes for the month of April. I say we, because some of my girlfriends were co-hosting it together. Weight loss challenge is gonna be held inside of the group Rockin' the Fab Life, but you need to register for it to participate. So click the link in Messenger, we'll put link in the comments. Click Messenger when you get that message. It'll say weight loss challenge. Click that. You can see the details there. Make sure you register. It's a Google form. All the details will be in there. I just did a video today in Rockin' the Fab Life with all the specifics. But let's crush it. Whether you want to lose weight, tone up, lose body fat, gain muscle, just feel awesome. I mean, seriously, how would it feel to feel awesome in your clothes? Let's get ready for summer, right? Let's get ourselves to be our best version of ourselves as well. So you can register for that. It's going to be awesome. Okay, guys, I have a speaking event I have to run off to. I'll try to post something in my stories on inflammation, anti-inflammatory foods. Isn't that fun? I'm so excited. All right, guys, have a great rest of the day. I'll see you later. Bye.